All right, what is going on, guys? Today we're going to be reacting to Mr. Clark himself, Ryan from Canada Coaster Fan's top 50 roller coasters he has ridden 2018. I've been getting more reaction requests to this video than any other. I will have a reaction coming out to an Infinite Coaster video and a Simply Sam top 100 in the next 2 days. So I just wanted to tell you guys that, but let's get right into this reaction. All right, top 50 roller coasters I've ridden 2018. Kind of nervous, but let's do this. Okay, 50 Olympia Looping. From what he's written, I can see that. I definitely think Olympia Looping is in... Oh, Texas Giant 49. Kind of low, but not bad. Yeah, I could definitely see it as one of the weaker arms, so wow. Yeah, I'm starting to think Goliath is better than New Texas Giant, for sure. Because Goliath looks really cool, guys. Like, what? The boss? Oh no, this is not going to be good. Wow. Legend. Dude, what? I thought you liked that more. Tremors. Ghost Rider? Okay, fair spot. Haven't quite grown on Ghost Rider yet myself, but I do find it to be a very, very nice looking roller. No, I think Legend's better than that. Raven looks like a meme. Banshee? No. Time Traveler. Not acceptable. What? Are you serious? Oh, big rip for Tehran. That's an ouch. I think Tehran looks overrated, kinda, eh. 39 Troy, fair enough. I like that spot. That is a really good spot, actually. In fact, that's a freaking perfect spot. Okay, Goliath. Okay. Solid spot, actually. I think in the world, I'd have it around 38. But for this list, I say that's good. Wow. That is kind of low. Okay. Superman the Ride with a bizarro POV. Yeah. Superman the Ride looks fun. 35 Cannibal. Yeah. Cannibal looks so cool, because some people say it has aspects of Carnon. That's kind of low. I honestly would... Okay, that's a... argument that's always thought about in the coaster community is Behemoth or Leviathan better, and personally I'm on the Leviathan side. 32 Montu, yeah. But back to the Leviathan thing, I don't know, they both look great. However, it's, you know, I don't know, guys, it's confusing, the whole thing. 31 Catoon, yes, agreeable. 30 the Joker. Okay. Fair enough. Holy crap, that is high. Gold Striker? Dude. 28 Kumba. Yes, Kumba looks great. Look at that airtime. Sight. Yeah, I'm starting to... Eye speed at 27. I feel like that should be higher. But yeah, like, I'm starting to... feel like Kumba's gonna be overrated for me because everyone tells me how good it is. 26 Outlaw Run, a little higher, but about the Kumba, I don't know, looks great, but I'm kind of scared. 25 Balder, definitely a good spot. Ugh, that's sluggish at the end. Ah, no, Irat should be higher. I don't even care about the quarry wall thing. I heard it's still really fun up there, and it's a lot faster apparently. Whoa! Magnum. Ah, look at Cyclone, yeah. Dude, Magnum, that's crazy. I can't believe that Storm Chaser. Depending on what he's ridden, I would put that high. Okay, Storm Chaser's better than Renegade, but surprise, surprise, Renegade is his number one GCI. That rhymed. 19 Fury. I'd put it kinda higher out of what he's ridden, but in the world, I'd literally put it at the 19 spot, most likely. You know what's depressing is I think Helix is better than it. Oh, heck no. Millennium Force is not better than Fury, or like a lot of coasters in front of it. Somebody Maverick, okay. Yeah, yeah. What? Dragster? Hey, Wonder Woman Golden Lasso. Raptors, dude. The Raptors are sick. Or Team Puritan. Kind of saw that coming. I knew it was going to be high. But, what? Dragster over Millennium and Maverick? 13 Helix, yes, yes, I love Helix. Oh my gosh, that thing looks top 15 in the whole world. Like, nah, that's kind of high, my man. Ooh, X2, yes, X2 looks amazing. I can see it being top 25 in the world. I could see it. I don't know if I would say it. But I can see it. So here we go. Top 10. Number 10 is probably going to be something like Wildfire. I can bet you 100% it's Wildfire. What did I tell you? What did I tell you? Wildfire. Solid spot. Here we go. Wildfire is something special. It is an elite RMC by far. I don't know if I would call it top 3. Because Twisted Timbers is airtime heaven. It makes no sense. You're laughing the whole time. It's crazy. But Wildfire is definitely up there. I could see it being a top 3 RMC. I could see it. Looks very intense, well-paced, one of the most well-rounded, long RMCs and coasters out there. Wow. That was good. Alright, number 9. I'm scared where I-305 is gonna go. No! Dude, coaster's not even that good. I mean, the airtime looks great. Like, it looks crazy, but, like, I heard it's really rough, and, like, it's just kind of dumb. Besides the airtime, this drop off the brake run, that's absolutely deadly. But I don't think it should be top 10, man. I respect your opinion for liking it, but I don't know. I don't see the hype around coaster at all. I don't know. I-305 is gonna be next. I know it. It's gonna be I-305. Repetitive. Okay, number 8. It's gonna be I-305. And what? Dude, I thought you liked that more. That dropped. That dropped, man. Wow. Cairnon, dude. Personally, I'd put that higher. But I see where you're coming from. I'm excited for Cairnon. I am so excited. Oh, It just looks amazing. The overall experience looks great. So, does this mean I-35's moved up? I don't know. If it didn't make it, there's something bad. But, like, it made it. I know it had to make it. Let's go. I-305 at number 7. Okay. I would put that higher. Here's the thing. I kind of freaked out over the other dudes putting I-305 at number 7. Dirty Coasters. Now, I recently thought about it, and I kind of overreacted. They were talking about the whole world. Now, Ryan, this should be higher, man. This should be higher. I'm trying to keep my cool because I've had a good day, but I would put it higher, man. I-305 deserves some more love. I mean, it is the world's most intense coaster, pretty much, and it's unbelievable what this thing is capable of. The aggressiveness level is out of this world, and if you haven't ridden Intimidator 305, you're in for a treat. Like, not even joking. So, here we go, number 6. Oh yeah. Skyrush, baby, let's go. Dude, Skyrush. This coaster was the most freaking beast mode ride of all time. It is, man, this ride is just complete and utter badass. I mean, like, it's so sick. I love Skyrush, man. That, I like it a little more than Twisted Timbers. And normally no one would say that, but hey, Skyrush, man. So intense. The airtime is crazy. All right. Here we go. Top 5. It's going to be G-Force or Lightning Rod. One of those two. Wait! This was his number? This was his... Okay, this was his number one for like the longest time. Now I understand, I knew Steel Vengeance was gonna make it over it. But this low? Dude, what happened with you? I thought Voyage was like... Oh no. I've lost hope for Voyage now. Man, I was always thinking this was gonna be like the greatest wooden coaster ever. Like, not including RMCs. Just, man, this sucks. I know the four coasters that are gonna be in front of it. I don't know the order, but I know which ones are gonna be in front of it, so. I didn't expect them to make it over Voyage, in all honesty. I low-key thought it was gonna be his number two. I thought it was gonna be his, back number two. All right, here we go. Ow, what the? What do you mean? Elrod? Okay. G-Force made it over Elrod. That makes me a little triggered. I think Elrod should be higher up here. I could see it being better than Toro. I could see it. I'm not saying that, but... Lightning Rod looks absolutely phenomenal. That's a coaster I could see being better than Voyage. I don't know about like G-Force or Toro or anything. That thing was crazy. That was an awesome ride. I haven't ridden in. I'm just saying the POV, like, just watching that. Number three. G-Force. Very high. Since that's his number one steel coaster, not including Steel Vengeance, like true steel, I don't know what to think. I mean, it's good that I-35's in his top three true steels, like Skyrush, this, and I-35, but I think I-35's better than both of them, if I'm being completely honest. That drop looks cool, but airtime looks fun, turns look decent. Just kind of Millennium Force 2.0, you know? Still looks phenomenal. It's a top 10 coaster on the planet, I'm telling you. I have his top two. I know his top two now, so. That turn. That was cool. There you go, airtime. Nice. Nice. There's a lot of these weird, like, side trim things every once in a while on this coaster, like, on the separate side of the track where it's, like, a straight section. I don't know what that's all about. I really don't. And there's no station. Like, there's, like, no station. It's just a platform. It's really cool. Number two is El Toro. Oh my god. You're using like the same music Dirty Coaster used. Is a burning thing. And it makes a fiery ring. Yeah, so in the previous video for Dirty Coaster's Top 100, I got roasted. Apparently this was not Elvis. Sorry, I'm a GP at country music or whatever. Apparently this is Johnny Cash. I know who both of them are, I just don't really listen to them, or I didn't. I would listen to Johnny Cash, but I never heard this. I thought this was Elvis. I don't know why. Oh, boy, that was a crazy ride. That's an Entenmann. That is definitely an Entenmann. Like a Rolling Thunder, looking like some trash. And the number one spot is Steel Vengeance. It's everyone's number one now. I don't even care anymore. Every list I'm gonna watch, the number one's gonna be Steel Vengeance, so I'm not even gonna be surprised anymore. Whatever. In fact, I'm gonna go through this POV since I'm gonna watch it anyway right now, and I will say an amazing, okay, or bad for each element that happens and what I think of them. So let's do this. First up is the drop, of course. Amazing. Okay. Probably amazing. Freaking amazing. That outer bank. Okay. Okay. Bad. Bad. I don't like that inversion. It looks kind of dumb. Okay. Okay. Bad. I heard this part was amazing. Okay. Okay. That's a good. That's amazing, I think. That's an okay one. Amazing. Okay. Amazing. Amazing! Pretty good. decent. Yes. Oh my gosh. His hills look fun, so I'm gonna give it a good. Those were good. Alright, so that's... Yeah, those hills look good. Thank you for watching. Alright, so that's the end of the video. Alright. So, Ryan from Canada Coaster Fan's Top 50 Coasters was just watched by me. What do I think of it? I thought it was really good. I liked that list a lot more than I thought I would. It was by far better than Dirty Coasters. Sorry, but like any list is better than Dirty Coasters. You know, I was kind of shocked by where he put Voyage, and I was not shocked by where he put Steel Vengeance. But overall, great list. I really enjoyed it. So yeah, everyone go subscribe to Canada Coaster Fan if you haven't already, because you probably all have. Don't forget to like and subscribe on all his videos. His content is awesome. Channel's awesome. Awesome. Don't forget to like and subscribe. And until next time, Coaster Fans, I will see you later. Peace out.